Julie, let's go back to how we met. So the story around us meeting is that I was a nurse at Sea Crest Hospice and had volunteered to be a photographer for patients and families at the end of life and for veterans who had ceremonies. And we took photos of those patients and families. Julie and her father, who was our patient, was one of those families that I had that opportunity to meet and to photograph on a very special day that was super fun. And that was the first time I met Julie.
Seacrest had always had a program that they kept bringing up to me saying, your dad was a vet in the Navy. He was an aviator. And we want to honor him as a vet. The most wonderful, wonderful ceremony came together. You had taken a photo of me side by side with my dad. Mm-hmm. And that's how I like to think, is that I was side by side during this journey of Alzheimer's and his final days and his final last chapter of his life. And we took that photo and we're smiling at you. And then I went and I was kissing his forehead. I'm grateful for that photograph. I was a family member of a hospice patient, and I ended up feeling a calling and a purpose of my life to go in to be a hospice volunteer. You showed me that love and that joy that can be preserved in a photograph.
It's interesting. We started that program in probably 2014, and we had no idea what impact it was going to have. People get photographed at weddings or proms or for special occasions, but not always at the end of life. And then when we started seeing these photos, we would get questions of, well, this is a hospice patient? Hospice patients aren't supposed to look like that. And why are they all smiling and laughing and having a good time? And what it ended up creating was education to the rest of us and to others. Hospice isn't that last breath. That it's living all the way through dying. The other part of the story that is with you is that as you turned and said you wanted to come into hospice and be a volunteer, I have a mother-in-law on service with Sea Crest Hospice. Now you're my hospice volunteer for my mother-in-law. When you see my mother-in-law and you type out what you've talked about, which, by the way, she talks to you, but she doesn't talk to most everybody else. You are able to converse with her, and then you type out what you talked about, and you send it to myself and my husband, and I've never seen my husband quite so moved when he reads your stories. So we do come full circle.